next three hot guys in your bullpen, you can do some stuff and shorten the game. You get a couple hot starters and a couple hot batters in the lineup, you got yourself a chance that can win it. And that's what really what the Braves were able to do. Brantley, 1-for-3 on the night. Braves fans in attendance starting to take over a little bit. The Astros fans don't like it. The organist helps drown it out. These fans in this ballpark, the fans back in Atlanta have been so great and provided such a great bed of sound underneath all these plays during the World Series. It's been thrilling to watch and call.
Outside.
That's outside, a full count. Two. That's a base hit by Brantley, and he's on to start the night. You know, when you go over the fact that the Astros are in the World Series for the third time over the last 5 years, you see that first year, 2017, and we know what was going on back then. Nobody around here denies it. The sign stealing, the scandal, the cheating. But they're past that. And now here they are back in the World Series when their owner, Jim Crane, asked Buck Showalter about who should manage this team after A.J. Hinch was fired. He said there's only one guy that should manage that team, and it's him.
Yeah.
Dusty Baker did an incredible job. Look, it is, they earned their way into this season. Long season after the shortened season last year, losing in 7 to the Rays. Correa in what could be his final at bat. And Houston Astros, the number one overall pick by Houston, and helped get them turned around. Starting back when he was selected in 2012.
Exactly, and they knew they were going to hear it and wear it. And last year was probably a break a little bit because not many fans were allowed to come. So they knew they were going to hear it everywhere they went. And they played with a chip on their shoulder, and they knocked off two pretty good teams to get to the World Series. And I don't think anybody feels like this wasn't their year to prove people they're still a really good team.
0-2 pitch is down. Last year in the COVID shortened year, the Astros finished 29-31. They beat Minnesota, beat Oakland, and forced 7 games against Tampa Bay under Dusty Baker. And now here they are in 2021, 5 games better than the Mariners in the AL West and back in the World Series. Here's one into right center field. Going to get it is Duvall. One on, one out. And the Braves are 2 outs away. Dusty Baker at 72 years old, the second oldest to lead a team to the World Series. Jack McKeon, 200 days older. Trader Jack turns 91 later this November. But what a job for Dusty Baker. But the rest of this ninth inning is going to belong to us talking about this Atlanta Braves team.
Yeah.
And Brian Snitker and his staff and this team that dealt with so much. Here's Alvarez. Strike one. 88 wins during the regular season. The Braves say to that, so what? No Acuna, no Soroka, no Ozuna. They lost Charlie Morton with a broken leg in game one of this World Series, and they just never blinked.
Yeah, I mean, there's a ton of teams that are going to talk about the injuries they had during the year and what they weren't able to overcome. The Braves overcame those injuries with the addition of certain guys that now became huge contributors to what looks like a world championship.
0-1 pitch, Alvarez takes a ball, one ball, one strike. Alex Anthopoulos and the job that he's done in his fourth year running the show with the Braves. Spent 6 years prior to that in Toronto. Tremendous work in the month of July. It's all paid off
here in October and into early November. You know, again, just to echo one more time, we have analytic numbers for everything, and there's a lot of good numbers that kind of tell you the story. The Braves have the it factor working for them, and that's inside the clubhouse, that's leadership, that's players. Houston had it as well, but it is pretty incredible. Here's a 1-2 pitch. Alvarez takes down from Smith, 2-2. You know, there is a former manager of the Atlanta Braves that's watching every pitch of this. Very proud of Brian Snitker and his former organization, talking about the great Bobby Cox.
Yeah, wish him the best. He's been battling, but you know he watches every game. Brian got to see him before he came out here.
Outside.
He doesn't miss a game. And Brian will get a chance to show him one more trophy.
Meanwhile, his son Troy is on the other side. Troy Snitker, one of the hitting coaches for the Houston Astros, watching his dad guide the Atlanta Braves to within one out of a championship.